Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna read a story on white mice. So let's get started. Once upon a time, there was a little boy who wanted to return to his parents after his summer vacations. His uncle Ken, who comes to the station to see his mom, puts him on the wrong train. When the boy realizes the mistake his uncle made, he gets down at Lucknow and send a telegram to his grandfather. The kind station master, Mr. Ghosh, keeps the boy safe till his grandfather reaches Lucknow and invites him to his house. Mr. Ghosh's house was just behind the station. He bought me a cup of sweet milky tea and two large rasgullas. "Now let me show you my family," he said, and took me by the hand and led me to a veranda at the back of the house. There was a miniature railway, complete with a station, railway bungalows, signal boxes, and next to it, a miniature fairground, complete with swings, a roundabout, and a Ferris wheel. 15 to 20 white mice were dancing on the roundabout and the Ferris wheel. Another dozen also ran in and out up tunnels and climbed up on a toy train. Mr. Ghosh pressed a button and the little train covered with white mice left the station and went rattling off to the far corner of the veranda. It was also impressive. By the time grandfather arrived, I had fed biscuits to the mice and fallen asleep in a huge armchair in Mr. Ghosh's living room. I woke up and find the station master busy showing grandfather his little railway colony of white mice. So grandfather was interested in the toy train, but he said polite things about the mice, commending their pink eyes and pretty little feet. Mr. Ghosh beamed with pleasure and sent out for more rasgullas. When grandfather and he had settled into the compartment of a train, later that night, Mr. Ghosh came to the window to say goodbye. As the train began moving, he thrust a cardboard box into my hands and said, "A present for you and your grandfather." More rasgullas, I thought. Later, when the train was underway and I lifted the lid of the box, I found two mice asleep on a bed of cotton wool. Back in there, I kept the white mice in the boxer. I had plans for them. After dinner, I slipped into my uncle's room and released the mice under his bed sheet. An hour later, we all had a leap out of our beds when Uncle Ken dashed out of his room screaming that something soft and furry was running about inside his clothes. "Well off with the clothes," said grandfather, giving me a wink. He said, "A good idea of what had happened." After Uncle Ken had done a tap dance on white mice, finally came out the clothes, but the other had run up the sleeve of his pajama coat and suddenly popped out beneath his chin. Uncle Ken started to panic, convinced that his room was full of mice, pink, white, and brown. He locked himself in the storeroom and slept on an old sofa. Next day, grandfather took me to the station and put me on the train to Delhi. It was the right train this time. "I will look after the white mice," he said. Grandfather gave quite fond of the mice and even wrote to Mr. Ghosh asking if he could spare another pair. But Mr. Ghosh, he learned later, he had been transferred to another part of the country and had taken his family of white mice with him. Thank you. If you like my video, please subscribe, like and share the video. Have a good day. Bye.